Okay, it's a new day and the project continues. I have done some work. I have removed a couple of straps and from here and from here. So now this starts to get open, wide open. And I think that I'm ready to remove the fuel rail, but first thing is to release the pressure out from here. So let's see how we can do that. Okay, so I don't have the correct kind of hose, so I have to improvise a little bit. I have this hose and I just made a little hole here so I can fit a screwdriver here, and let's see how the pressure comes out if I press this knob. Oops. Okay, the extra pressure is out of the fuel system, a couple of drops is coming out, and the next thing to do is to remove this one. There might be some fuel coming out of here, so I have an old towel catching the fuel. But only a couple of drops because there's no pressure in the system. As I'm going to pull this up, there might be some extra fuel coming out from here, so let's see how that goes. But the next thing to do is to remove these bolts off the fuel rail and here too, and then just lift the fuel rail and the fuel injectors up. So we are going to need a tool. Okay, some magic happened. Meanwhile, my camera was a little bit broken and I was able to remove the fuel train. And boy, those injectors, they are dirty. They are dirty. Oh no. It would be wise to replace these rubber seals, but I don't have any new ones, so I just have to use them what I have. Now I have the intake manifold up. I removed 8 bolts here, and after that I realized that I took the fuel rail out, but that shouldn't have been done at this point, so don't take those out like I did. The next thing was to take two pneumatic lines out of. There is one here, and they were quite tight, but I just grabbed them with these and started to pull, and after a while they just got off, so they are not locked anyhow, but you have to pull quite hard. Okay, the next thing is to lift the wall manifold up, and then we are in halfway. Okay, now the intake manifold is taken out. It was quite easy to thing to do, but I had to lose some of these so I could get them out of the way. The main idea was to pull it from the front and then just pull it out, so it doesn't, there's not enough room to lift it up straight, but you can get it out by lifting it diagonally. There's some water at the bottom of the motor because I washed I cleaned the motor some, so I have to take those water out, and I have to cover all these. I can see the valves there, but I have to cover these so nothing gets inside there. And I have to try to do some cleaning. I have to try to get those more cleaner. So, but this is the intake manifold. This would have been the correct time to remove the fuel rail, but I did it too early. I'm going to have to take this one out, few bolts here, and then I can check inside what's wrong there. But let's see if these are okay, because that would be a very bad thing. It seems that there all the parts are there. These are intact, so they are okay. The main problem is probably inside this manifold. So the next thing to do is to remove this one. Okay. The bolts are off and here we go. Before I start to put these things back together, let me show you something about this old manifold. Check this out. What the heck? I'm not sure if you can see. What is this? This is completely wasted unit. As you can see, these are all loose. If we compare it to the new one, nothing. This is all tight and as supposed. Nothing, no sounds. If I put my hand here, you can hear. And here, nothing. Oh my god, I can't believe this. Now we are in halfway and it's time to start to put things back together. Okay, first thing to do, this is the old one, old gasket, but the new came along with the intake manifold. But these gaskets, I had to buy separately. So this came along with the intake manifold, so you don't have to buy this one. And you should go here like this. Okay, now it's correctly positioned. The next thing to do is to install the fuel rail back to the manifold. And this is easy thing to do here, because you just have to put it down. But like I said, it might be wise to replace these seals, because they are old, but I don't have new ones, so I just put. press them to the bottom. Like this. Okay. Now it's in the place. Then just put the bolts in place. Today's task is to clean all things up and put things back together. First thing to do is to clean all these up. I have sprayed some engine cleaner here, and I have put something that prevents dirt and objects getting into the intake track. That's important because if there's something inside there, if something goes inside there, an engine failure can occur. So keep things out. After I have cleaned all this up, I'm going to do some vacuum cleaning and try to make this as clean as possible. Oh, I just finished vacuum cleaning all these intakes. Let's see what's inside there. That looks clean. This one also. Nothing there. Okay. This one is okay. Also clean. So it is. Okay. So next thing to do is to put new gaskets to the manifold. It's important to get new ones, don't use old ones, because they are not going to seal it properly and there's going to be a vacuum leak. So buy new ones. These both have different codes. So left has own code and right one also. Okay. Like this. When I removed the old intake manifold, I pulled out this completely with this plastic part also, but now I realize that the new intake has new ones, so I only going to need this tube, and it was quite tight. I couldn't get it out, but then I realized if I just twist it with two hands, it comes off quite easily. So don't try to pull this out. It won't come out easily, but if you start to twist it, it suddenly gets loose and you can get it out quite easily. Here we go. Now the intake manifold is in place. I got a friend who helped me because it was pain to install by myself. Somebody has to grab these cables and pipes and stuff like that and move them away from the when I was installing. And like I did it in the when I was taking it off, I put it in 45 degrees, and before I got it in place, I connected this wire to this connector, and what else? This vacuum pipe. You can install it later from here, but it would be wise to put it in when the in manifold is in 45 degrees. One tip, which I realized, the gaskets, they didn't stay where they should. So I took the manifold out and put some wire around these. So all the four sides, corners, and that kept the gasket in place. So it was quite easy to fit it. And now I just start to put all the bolts and nuts back in place, and all these wires also, the fuel line. I just do it in reversed order, and I think in a couple of hours I can try this engine if it still starts. But now it's time to put things back together. One thing I will clean all this with air essential clean. This is good stuff. Just clean all the connectors. Everything is put back in together, and every single wire is back in place, and every tube is in place, and also the vacuum pump is in place. So the next thing to do would be the testing. So let's install the air filter module. There is one important thing to do when you're installing the air filter, because this part does not go into the part underneath it. So you have to push it really hard. You can feel how it sticks. It stays quite firmly here. Now it's in place, and you should not be able to put any fingers to here. So if your finger goes inside the air filter, there's a gap and it's not placed correctly, and that will cause many troubles. Okay, the final piece. And let's see how it starts. Yes. Very nice, very nice. This engine is so completely different engine than before. Earlier the idle was very rough. The whole engine was shaking a lot. I can hear lots of misfires. It sounds very stable, sounds very good. It doesn't shake at all. It's almost like a brand new. So I would say that this fix was a successful fix. Now I'm very glad. Next thing to do is to test drive.